morning everyone. This is Jweria Dalit, PGT Maths from TSMS Muttrachpalli Gajwel. Today we are discussing the probability and its revision. So in the previous class, in your 9th standard, you have studied the words extremely likely, almost certain, unlikely and impossible terms. Means extremely likely is there is much chance for it to happen, certain we are sure that it is going to happen, unlikely means there is less possibility for it to happen, and impossible is something which is not possible. Then the measurement of possibility, it can be measured numerically, which is referred as probability. So what is probability? If an experiment is conducted, which is to toss a coin 100 times, then if the heads have turned up 45 times and the tail turned up 55 times, then the possibility of getting heads out of 100 times is 45. So it will be measured as out of 100 we got 45 times, so it is 45 by 100, so the probability will be 0.45. this estimation of probability is based on the results of an actual experiment of tossing a coin 100 times. This estimates are called experimental or empirical probabilities. Of course, if the same experiment is repeated, we will definitely not get the same data. So this is considered as an experimental probability. Then theoretical. What is in this? It is, suppose a fair coin is tossed at random. Fair means there is no partiality, means there is heads and tails. Also the coin is symmetrical. There is no possibility that certain side will be appearing whenever you are tossing, or it is not biased coin. So it is considered as a fair coin. So for basic understanding of probability, we assume that all the experiments have equally likely outcomes. That is, the experimental or empirical probability, P of E of an event E, is denoted as P of A is number of trials in which the event happened by total number of trials. Let us understand few terms. That is random experiment. Random experiment is experiment in which we know the possible outcomes before conducting the experiment, but we cannot predict the exact outcome that occurs at a particular time. When you are tossing a coin, you know what are the possibilities. Definitely it will be a head or a tail, but what will become as the final output, the final result, that cannot be predicted. Same in the case of dice. It will be all the possibilities we know, but what will be the final result, that cannot be predicted. This is called as random experiment. Next is equally likely outcomes. Equally likely events. Two or more events are said to be equally likely if each of them has an equal chance of occurrence. Again, if I am considering a coin, the possibility for a head and a tail to come as a result is equal. So this is considered as equally likely. Also, if a die is considered, there is no special each side is only once, so it is, there is no possibility that the dice is having different numbers on each of its sides. So there is possibility for any number to occur is only once. So such events are called as equally likely events. The mutually exclusive. Two or more events are mutually exclusive if the occurrence of an event prevent occurrence of all other events. Means if there is a selection from the class 8, 9, 10th. Okay, if a student is selected, definitely she cannot be selected again. So occurrence of one event is preventing the other. This is mutually exclusive event. Next is complementary. Complementary is if we are considering an event, consider an event has few outcomes. Event of all other outcomes in the sample space which are not in the favorable event is denoted as E bar. For example, I'm tossing the coin. I want a head to appear, but apart from head, if the tail is coming as the output, then that is considered as its complementary event. So it is denoted as E bar. Then exhaustive events. All the events are exhaustive if their union is a sample space. So if all the the next one is sure event. An event whose occurrence is sure or certain is called sure event. Its probability will be 1. An impossible event is an event which cannot occur on any account is called an impossible event, and probability of such an event will be 0. Let us go through few examples. If a bag contains lemon flavored candies only, Malini takes out one candy without looking into the bag. What is the probability that she takes out? The first bit is an orange flavored candy, second one is a lemon flavored candy. So as the bag is containing lemon flavored candy, definitely getting an orange flavored candy from the bag is not possible, that it is 0. So the probability of getting an orange flavored candy is 0. So the next and B bit is lemon flavored candy. As the bag is containing lemon flavored candy, the possibility of it is considered as 1. This is something which is sure event. Case example, A bit was an impossible event, so its probability is 0. Next, if a die is rolled once, find the probability of getting. First bit is a prime number, second bit is a number lying between 2 and 6, and third bit is an odd number. If a coin is tossed, if a dice is rolled, then the possible outcomes will be the 6 sides, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So the number of outcome, that is sample space, n of s is 6. So first bit, so the probability is number of favorable outcomes by total number of outcomes. And the first bit is probability of getting a prime number. Out of the sample space 1 to 6, we are having 3 prime numbers, which is 2, 3 and 5. So the numerator, that is favorable outcome, is 3, by the total number of outcomes is 6. 3 by 6, which is 1 by 2. Coming to second bit, a number lying between 2 and 6. So the numbers lying between 2 and 6 are 3, 4 and 5. Again, they are also 3. So the number of favorable outcomes is 3 by 6, which is the total number of outcomes or the sample space. So it is 3 by 6, which is equal to 1 by 2. Coming to third bit, probability of getting an odd number. So in the sample space, the odd numbers we have are 1, 3 and 5, which will be again the numerator, that is number of favorable outcomes for being an odd number is 3, by the total number of outcomes is 6. So 3 by 6, which is equal to 1 by 2. Next, before going to this problem, we will see what a deck of cards. A deck of cards is will contain 52 cards. In this 52 cards, you will be having 4 categories, that is there will be red diamonds and red hats. Similarly, there will be black spades and black clubs. In each of them, again, the cards will be numbered from 2 to 10. And along with that, there will be three pictured cards, which is a king, a queen, and a jack. So in each category, there will be 13 cards. Means within, for example, hearts. In hearts, you will be having total 13 cards, which is numbered from 2 to 10. And a king, a queen, and a jack. The same will be in all the other three cards also. Sorry, in other three shapes as well. So the total, so now coming to the problem, one card is selected from well shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability of getting first one, a king of red color. Second one is a face card. So first one is okay. Now coming to the number of cards, total number of cards are 52, and the probability is number of favorable outcomes by total number of outcomes. So probability of an event is number of favorable outcomes by the total number of outcomes. So the first bit is probability of king of red color. Red, it means we will be having diamonds and hearts. In both of them, you will be having one king in diamond and one king in hearts. As they are red color, it is specified that it should be in red color. So you are having only two kings out of, so the favorable outcomes are 2 by the total outcomes, which is 52, which is 1 by 26. Next is probability of a face card. So in each card, in each type, you are having 3 face cards. So total you will be having 12 face cards. So the number of favorable outcomes is 12 by the total number of outcomes, which is 52, that is 3 by 13. Next, probability of a red face card. So you are having red diamonds and red hearts. So the total number of face cards in red are 6. So the number of favorable outcomes are 6 by the total number of outcomes is 52, which is 3 by 26. Then probability of jack of heads. In hearts, jack of hearts. In hearts, there is only one jack. So it will be the probability for selecting that card is only 1 by 52. Then probability of a spade. Spade will have 13 cards. So its probability will be 13 by 52, which is 1 by 4. Then the fourth one, probability of the queen of diamonds. In diamonds, there will be only one queen, so it is 1 by 52 cards. Next one is two dice, one red and one yellow, are thrown at the same time. What is the probability that the sum of two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is 8, 13, less than or equal to 12? So if you see the box, there are the different possibilities, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So dice will have 6 sides. Similarly, when two dice are tossed, the total number of possible outcomes will be 36, with the combination. For if you see the first row, it is 1, 1, means both the dice when rolled, for in both the cases the outcome is 1. And next one is, for the first die is 1, second die is 2. Like this, all the possibilities will be having the total possible outcomes as 36. So the first bit is, if we are supposed to find the probability that the sum of two numbers appearing on the top of the dice is 8. So in that case, there are only 5 possibilities, which is 2, 6, 3, 5, 4, 4, 5, 3 and 6, 2. So the number of favorable outcomes to this event, that is 5 out of total, that is 36. The next one is second bit is 13. If you see, the maximum number is, maximum combination is 6, 6, that is 12. So there is no possibility that when two dice are rolled, you will be getting a number more, a number as 13. So this is considered as an impossible event. So the probability is zero, and all the outcomes which are favorable to the event, such that the sum of two numbers appearing on it is less than or equal to 12. So all the combinations that we have in the box will be less than or equal to 12. So the probability in this case is 36 by 36, that is equal to 1. So what we have discussed, what is experimental probability and theoretical probability. Then theoretical probability is represented as P of P, which is number of favorable outcomes by total number of outcomes. Then the probability of a sure event will always be 1. Similarly, probability of an impossible event will always be 0. And the probability of an event is a number, P of E will always lie between 0 and 1. An event having only one outcome is called an elementary event. The sum of the probabilities of all the elementary events of an experiment is 1. And for any event, P of E plus P of E bar is equal to 1, where E bar stands not for not E. Thank you. Hope you have understood the topic well.